Hi everyone, Tony here, and welcome to the second part of Magmaflow tutorial. Connect to me on Facebook if you like for the latest updates and other VFX stuff, and you can get there by clicking here if you are seeing this on Vimeo, or by clicking this link here on my YouTube channel, or by going to facebook.com/tonyfx. Anyway, this time we will see how to select particles using Magmaflow editor based on different properties of those particles, and also we will use the Krakatoa delete modifier to delete the selected particles to achieve certain kind of effects. In this scene, I have loaded a single frame of cast particles which was created using a PRT volume object and a texture applied to it for better visual purpose only. Now we will apply a KCM to the selected to select particles based on a texture map and delete the selected particles using Krakatoa delete modifier. So let's open the editor and change the output to selection type. We will use a texture map to define our selection, and for this example we will use a noise map. Particles in the white area will get selected and those in the black will remain unselected. By tweaking these values here, you can adjust the area of our selection. Now since selection only reads numeric values, we have to convert this texture map into a scalar quantity. And as always, this operator requires an integer as well. So we will bring in an integer input and feed this to the convert operator. Now you can see the selected particles are getting deleted. You can also animate these values to get something like you saw in the preview of this tutorial. And as long as you are using the procedural textures like dense cellular and noise etc, it's fine. But if you want to use a bitmap or a non-procedural texture that needs texture coordinates, you have to save texture coordinates while casting. So go ahead and try it yourself, and I'm gonna move to the next example. So in this example, we'll delete particles based on their direction of motion. I have loaded some particles here which you might be familiar with if you have seen the previous tutorial on Magmaflow, and if you missed it, I suggest you watch that. So what we have here is a PRT loader with some particles loaded, and I have assigned a custom color using a KCM since I didn't save any color channel before. Alright, let's add a KCM. And a Krakatoa delete modifier on top, and open the editor. Make the output as selection type and the input to velocity. As always, the selection needs to be a numeric value, so we will take only the scalar component of the velocity vector. And define that component axis with an integer input. As you may know from the previous tutorial, an integer value of 1 means the x component. You can see the particles moving along the positive x direction are getting selected and therefore getting deleted. Now if I change the integer value to 2, it will take the y component of the velocity vector into account and delete the particles that are moving along the y axis. If you notice carefully, you can see the particles moving on the x-shaped plane remains unselected, and those which are moving in the positive y direction are getting selected and therefore getting deleted. A value of 3 deletes a particle moving along the positive x-axis. Now let's say we want to put a threshold on this value. means we want the particles moving in a certain direction to get deleted only if they exceed a certain speed limit. So what we have to do is compare the speed to a threshold value using a logic operator before feeding the particle to the output channel. And we will use a float input to define our threshold. We will convert the result of this logic operator to a float value and feed this to the output channel. Now you can see as I increase the threshold, less particles are getting deleted because, unlike all the particles getting selected as before, only particles having speed above this threshold value are getting selected now. So this way you can have control over selecting particles based on their speed and direction of motion. Alright, here I'm using a spear gizmo to select particles and delete the particles based on that selection. I will delete the KCM here and we will build from scratch. Now before we build our flow, let's talk about the theory. What we need to do is find out the distance between the particle and the center of the gizmo and compare that to its radius. If the distance is less than the radius, then the particle will get selected, otherwise not. In other words, if a particle is inside the gizmo, it will get selected and those outside will not. So let's see how we can achieve this using Magmaflow. So we will read the position data of the particles by selecting the position channel. And using a vector input, we will read the position of the spear gizmo. Now by subtracting these position values, we will get the distance between the particles and the center of the gizmo. Since the distance is always a positive quantity, we will take the magnitude of the resulting vector. Now we will compare this value with the radius of the spear gizmo. So we will copy this gizmo radius through the float input here. We will convert the output of this logic operator to a float value and feed this to the selection output. Now you can see the particles get deleted as they get inside the spear. Now watch this. If I move the PRT loader from the origin, this is all messed up. As you can see, the particles are still getting deleted without even getting inside the gizmo. The reason for this is we are calculating the position of the gizmo in the wall space and not in object space. So what we need to do is use a form world operator to get the position of the gizmo in object space. Now you can see no matter where I put the PRT loader, this works properly. In this last example here, I'm using the color channel which I saved during casing. I will convert this to a scalar quantity like we always do when we are using the selection as output. And we can do some interesting animations like this. I suggest you play around using different input channels and see what interesting look you can come up with. In the last installment of this Magmaflow tutorial, I will show you some other interesting stuff, so do join me on Facebook for the latest updates, and till next time, take care.